All right, guys, what is happening? Simon here. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to revalve your brake master cylinder in your early 90s Toyota. Now, this theory will be very similar or almost identical for a lot of other cars. However, I am revalving a Toyota master cylinder on an early 90s Toyota Celica, because you guys know, as I spoke about previously here on the channel, the brakes are completely shot in this car. When I got it, super soft pedal, I could press the pedal to go all the way down to the floor. I was like, ah, it's probably just low on fluid, but there's a reason it's gonna be low on fluid, because it is a sealed system. Opened up the boot and there was an empty bottle of brake fluid. So I knew it had a leak somewhere. We're just doing a full overhaul. Rebuilt the rear calipers, going to rebuild the front, got new pads, got new discs, got new braided lines. I was going to replace the hard lines, but they're actually in really good shape. So the last step is to rebuild the front calipers and then revalve this master cylinder. So let's get stuck in. I'm going to show you the tools you need for this job. I'm going to show you exactly how to do it and a little couple of tips and tricks along the way, mistakes that I've made in the past that you guys don't want to make. So guys, as always, if you like my stuff, please hit the thumbs up down below and the subscribe. Helps me out, helps the YouTube algorithm them out, and in turn means you're going to see more of my videos. All right, legends, so super simple. First thing you're going to need is a pair of gloves. I've got these gloves. I did go through a lot of the latex gloves, but I just kept tearing those apart. So we've got the fabric ones now, and I can just wash my hands in those fabric gloves and it works all the same. I don't have to keep changing the gloves. All right, so a little wire brush here. I'm just going to clean the outside of the master cylinder. 10 mil spanner to take out the retaining screw, and then I have a plunger thing just to push everything in so I can take it all out. New brake fluid here, because when I put the new parts in, I'm going to lubricate those in brake fluid. I'm going to do that in a clean container, because this one is absolutely filthy, as you can see. Now, here's the stock master cylinder, the original one, out of the vehicle. As you can see, it's absolutely filthy. Just going to give it a clean down. I'm going to clean it whilst everything's still inside it, because I don't want to be getting all the crap and everything inside and then replacing all the parts. Okay, here is the retaining screw that retains the rods inside that have the springs and everything. I'm not going to be taking the reservoir off today because I don't have seals for it, but I'm going to leave that on. But this is your brake master cylinder. So I'm just going to give this a bit of a clean. Just dry it off. Already looks better. Maybe I can just put this back in the car now and it'll work. Chance would be a fine thing, hey. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to press down in here. Now, easiest way would be to put it in a vise, but I don't have a vise, so I'm gonna put it in the old ice cream container. I'm gonna press that down, and then I'm gonna undo this retaining screw. That's gonna enable me to then take this circlip out and then pull everything out from the inside. When you do this, just make sure you do it inside an old tub, because you never know if there's any brake fluid or anything left inside the master cylinder, and there probably is, so we'll push that down. Oh, and you can hear all the brake fluid coming out anyway. Let's see, which way is this gonna go? Push this down. Then you need to have some of these circlip pliers, and we're literally just going to place those into there. Pull this out. It says, easier said than done, by the looks of things. Now, when you pull everything out, here is my new kit. And you can see I have the two pistons with the springs, the circlip, and then the big O-ring at the end. When you pull everything out, make sure you take note of the order that it comes out in, because as you can see that those are different. So pull one out. Then little tap on the end and the other one comes out. Now you can see that they are different. So this one was in the bottom, right down the bottom end. And then this one was the last one. So the first one that came out, last one to go back in. Put that there. Then all we're gonna do is we're just gonna have a look inside, make sure that it's not scored. If it's scored or anything inside, you're gonna need a new master cylinder, but this one looks pretty good. I am just going to put a little bit of brake fluid through there. A little bit of fresh fluid through there. Always wear gloves when you're messing around with brake fluid. It's pretty nasty stuff. There we are. Oh, that's better. Sweet, cool. So I'm just gonna leave that sit there. And then, as I said, we're going to use some new, clean, fresh brake fluid. Take these out first. First. This one, second. So we're just going to put little bit of brake fluid on these. You don't want to use like a dissolvent or anything like that. And then we'll just slide them up on in there like that. There we go. And when I took it off, you can see the old one has these grooves on it. The new one does as well. These grooves are at the top. Just take note of where they are when you take it off, just so everything goes back in the right order. Yeah. There. You can see all lined up there. Cool. Push this one back in. Right. Then we have the direct opposite of everything as it comes back out. So we've got the circlip that is going to be an absolute pain in the butt to get back in. In there, make sure that it's in nice, seated in really well. That went in way easier than I expected it to as well, which is really good. And then the last bit, guys, is a new copper washer. You guys can see that down here, new copper washer just there. Whenever you take something off that has a copper wash on it, they use copper washers because they compress. So get rid of the old one and always replace it with a new one. If it is a copper washer and you don't have a new one, don't take it off. It's that simple. So this is so much harder to push down now. And there you have revalved Toyota Brake Master cylinder for it to go into the car. Over there. Right there. Doink. Guys, as always, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please remember, hit the thumbs up button. I'm going to shove that down before I put brake fluid over here. Hit the thumbs up button down below and subscribe for more content. Thank you so much.